Welcome to the Optimum CAD Solution. I am Pankaj Ratnaparkhi. Once again, we'll start our free online course that is Plastic Product Design and Advanced CATIA. Today, we are focusing towards our next tutorial, which is related to the advanced surfacing, and we'll design a simple surfacing component. So here is the 2D drawing of our component, and with respect to the dimensions given, we'll convert this 2D into the 3D. So without wasting the time, let's open the CATIA and start for the design. So here is the isometric view, and we are going to convert this total 2D into the 3D by using the surfacing command. So we'll open the CATIA now, and those are the few dimensions. So start. So we are using the generative shape design. So shape design, generative shape design. So whatever the name, just I will keep as a tutorial number 20. So here we are into the GSD, that is generative shape design. As usual, we'll start with a point and then axis system. So here the origin point is get created. So we'll hide the default planes. So now let's start with the 2D drawing. So first of all, we'll see whatever the drawing we have currently. So here the front view. See, this is the isometric view. From that we can see that firstly we have to draw this arc, which having the diameter of a 200, radius 100, and the dimensions 35 mm. So here we are into the 2D draw. So first of all, we have to draw that circle. This is exactly tangent to that horizontal, so we'll keep as a tangent here, and we'll give the dimensions as there is a R100, so we'll keep as a 200 diameter. As we know that either you can use the circle also, or you can use the arc also, but here we had used the circle, that's why we have to maintain this arc. But you can see there is no any dimensions, and this 90, if you see, we have to cut that. So we'll take an imaginary angle here for our arc. So you have to give the angle here. Unnecessary part will erase. So here the arc is get completed. So the dimension is 35 mm. So here is that 35. Now next, this edge is almost 117 mm. So we'll offset one plane, which is exactly 117 mm from the initial plane. So here is the 170. So by using this plane, we'll draw that remaining arc. So same, firstly we'll take a reference of a previous arc. Here we had taken the reference, and now we'll draw a new circle. Either you can draw a circle or a arc, whatever you required. So from the drawing you can see that both circles having the same origin point or a center point, and it is 30 mm offset. It means the diameter is 200 plus 30 plus 30 260, and as usual we'll keep as a profile like arc. So we'll erase unnecessary part. Now here the two basic surfaces are get created almost. So now we'll extrude. This is the first one, and we'll extrude another one, which is 60 mm dimensions. So here you can see 60 mm. So now this flange, or in between that, we need to draw that remaining surface, and for that we'll use the multi surface command. So in the multisex surfaces, you just have to select that edges, and here you can see the multi section is get created. So intermediate surfaces get created. Now we need to apply the radiuses, but before that we'll join both all three surfaces here. After then we'll use the radiuses here. So this is the 20 mm radius. So you can see the shape is get created. Now just the one operation is get remained. So now let's we'll move towards that last operation, but before that we'll apply one simple color here for proper visualization. So this cutout we need to require, and here you can see that this is the profile where we have to cut our basic profile or a basic surface. So let's we'll go into the sketch, and we'll by using the dimensions we'll extract another surface for cutting purpose. So for this sketch we'll use horizontal and vertical like this. Okay, so here we're into the sketch now. So let's take a references first. So edge to edge it is common, that's why we'll take a edge to edge references. Now here we had taken that, and now we'll try to do the basic cutout shape first. After then we'll apply the dimensions. So this is the exactly mirror from the center axis, and here the dimensions. So you can see that firstly this angle is 154 and this 90, this 50. So let's apply the dimensions. So this one is a 90. Already we had taken the mirror extent, that's why no need to apply symmetry command or a dimension symmetric here. This one is a 50 mm. Here is the 50, and this angle is 154.46. We'll confirm once again. Yes, 154.16, 46, 445, 154.45. Yes. And now the one dimension is get remained, and we'll consider it as a 25. So once we completed this, our sketch is converted into the ISO constraint here. Now let's remove unnecessary lines. And finally, we completed that. Corner radiuses are missed, so we'll apply that corner radiuses. So here 40, and here is the 40 40 10. So here we applied almost all the corners with having radius of a 10 mm and 40 mm. So the sketches get completed. Let's extract here. So we'll extract this in a Z direction, or we can see the horizontal vertical directions. So here is whatever the dimension is required, just we have to use this extrude for cutting purpose. So let's split this one with respect to the split 4, and here you can see the internal shape we required. So this is not necessary, so we'll hide that one. And now the final surface we achieved at this is the final surface. Now just the thickness is remaining. So from drawing, we'll consider we have the 2 mm thickness. I think we'll confirm once again, but here is the final surface. So the 2 mm here. So for the thickness, definitely we have to come into the solid. That's why we came into the part design, and after then we'll just apply the required thickness into the part body. So here is the command thick surface, and just you have to select that particular surface, give the required dimensions and arrow direction. So part is get completed by using the surfacing. This part is looking like a simple, only 3 or 4 surfaces there, but the process or the thinking, what kind of a commands or what kind of a surfaces we are using, that is somewhat imaginary, or you need to think about that. So you can see now the 2D and 3D get matches. Today's video is get completed. Thank you for watching our YouTube channel. We'll try to share more and more technical knowledge related to the plastic product design and advanced cut here. But before that, you have to subscribe, like and share our videos, and do not forget to hit the bell icon. Thank you guys.